and the bicarb is 15. We go to step 1 and we look at the pH. We know if the pH is above 7.45, there is alkalosis. So this patient has alkalosis, and again, as I said earlier, we start writing the diagnosis from the right to the left. So we write the diagnosis of alkalosis first. Step 2, we look at the PaCO2 in relation to alkalosis. The PaCO2 here is decreased along with alkalosis, so this alkalosis is respiratory. So we write the diagnosis of respiratory before the alkalosis, so it becomes respiratory alkalosis. So easy. We have already completed 2/3 of the diagnosis for this patient. Next step, step 3, we look for change in pH, for 10 millimeter change in PaCO2. Here the PaCO2 is 20, the normal mean is 40, so the PaCO2 has fallen by 20. The pH is 7.46 in this patient, the normal mean is 7.40, so the change from mean is 0.06. Let's wear our math hat. For 20 millimeter decrease in PaCO2, the pH has increased by 0.06. So for 10 millimeter decrease in PaCO2, it has increased by 0.03, and that fits the diagnosis of chronic nature of the respiratory alkalosis. So it is chronic respiratory alkalosis, and we write the term chronic before the term respiratory, and it becomes chronic respiratory alkalosis. And as we saw earlier, we wrote the diagnosis from right to the left. First we decided it is alkalosis, then we decided it is respiratory, and then we decided it is chronic. Now let's look at what's going on with the bicarb. The PaCO2 we have already seen. The bicarb is 15 in this patient, and the normal mean is 25, so the bicarb has decreased by 10. So for 20 millimeter decrease in PaCO2, the bicarb has decreased by 10. So for 10 millimeter decrease in PaCO2, the bicarb has decreased by 5, and this again meets the criteria for pure chronic respiratory alkalosis, and this confirms that the blood gas report is correct. So simple. 4 steps. First step, acidosis or alkalosis based on pH. Second step, PaCO2 in relation to acidosis or alkalosis. Third step, change in pH for 10 millimeter change in PaCO2. And the fourth step, change in bicarb for 10 millimeter change in PaCO2. Chronic respiratory alkalosis is not very common in clinical practice. Beware giving this diagnosis to a patient, and before you decide that the patient has chronic respiratory alkalosis, make sure you have ruled out other disorders, you have ruled out mixed disorders, and you have ensured that the given blood gas test report is correct. And to do that, you use hydrogen ion formula. You can see more details on this formula and how hydrogen ion corresponds to the pH in the book. Let's look at the causes of respiratory alkalosis. Just on the same model that we saw the causes of respiratory acidosis, we will see what are the causes of respiratory alkalosis. You can refer to the book, to the essentials of ABG part, where these things are explained much more in detail. The impulses generated in the brain and brainstem can be affected by encephalitis, anxiety,